I used to spend hours manually trying to match the lighting of my footage to the 3D environment. It was time consuming and quite frustrating. Today I'll show you how to match the lighting in your footage to any 3D environment using Switch Light Studio. And yes, we'll be using AI for this. I know what you might be thinking, another AI tool, but I felt the same at first. But here's the thing, if it can improve your workflow and save you countless hours of tweaking, why not use it? To download Switch Light Studio, go over to beeble.ai and click on the download link. Before diving into Switch Light Studio, there's one important step. You need to remove your background and make sure your footage has an alpha channel. If you filmed on a green screen, great, just key yourself out. If not, we'll attempt to take out the proto brush. Once you have downloaded and installed Switch Light Studio, open it up. You can either sign in with your Google account or create a new one. Once you have finished logging in, wait for this download to finish. Now there's a bunch of useful stuff Switch Light Studio can do, but we are interested in this one. In Switch Light Studio, start by selecting Extract Maps, import your footage or image sequence, choose an output folder and hit Extract. It will generate essential maps like albedo, roughness and the normal maps, all set for Blender. These maps let you relight your footage as if you shot it in a different environment. However, there's a small trade-off. The footage might appear slightly blurry, losing some fine details. And I will show you how to bring those details back later in the video. Before I start working on the environment and lighting, I need to track the footage first. Quick heads up, this tutorial won't cover camera tracking, but if you want to learn it, check out my previous video. And for those looking for something more advanced, I've got a new camera tracking tutorial coming soon with some useful Blender techniques, so stay tuned. But I'll quickly go over how I tracked this footage and got myself moving inside the 3D environment. For this, I'm using After Effects 3D camera tracker. To avoid confusing the tracker with a moving subject, I roughly mask myself out before tracking. Once the tracking is done, I'll use an add-on called AE to Blend to transfer the tracked camera into Blender. Next, I'll import my footage into Blender as a mesh plane. Using the copy attributes add-on, I'll match the mesh plane's location and rotation to the camera. Now in edit mode, I'll reposition the plane so it fits perfectly within the camera frame. Back in object mode, I'll scale the mesh until my subject's feet touch the ground. And then parent the plane to the camera. Since the camera is moving, the scale might need adjustments throughout the shot to fix any slipping. I'll add keyframes to fine-tune the scale, ensuring the feet stay grounded. It's a quick and forgiving process, and just like that, your character will move in 3D space as if they were really there. In Blender, import your albedo map as a mesh plane. Head over to the Materials tab and connect your normal map using a normal map node. And set it to non-color. Now your footage will seamlessly react to the environment's lighting. To demonstrate, I'll quickly model a small hallway and show you how it all comes together. Here's a quick tip to make a single image texture look more realistic. First, connect your image texture to the roughness input using a color ramp node. This will let you fine-tune how reflective different areas appear. Now, connect the image texture to the normals input through a bump node, but keep the strength settled to avoid an exaggerated effect. Now, add a hue and saturation node between the base color and the image texture. Bring in a noise texture and press Ctrl T on your keyboard to automatically add the texture coordinate node, if you have the Node Wrangler add-on enabled. Adjust the scale and detail of the noise, then connect it to the hue and saturation node's vector input through a color ramp to control its influence. You can also mix multiple textures using this technique to create even more complex and realistic surfaces. If you find these videos helpful and want to support the channel or grab some exclusive project files, consider joining my Patreon. Your support really helps me keep creating content like this. Alright, let's jump into the details. In order to get the details back, you need to re-render your original footage using the same mesh blend. Because for this method to work, both of the footages need to be in the exact same position. Select the mesh blend and change the albedo texture to the original footage you used in Switchlight Studio. Now disconnect your normal map and connect your footage to the emission color and put the strength to 1. Now turn off everything except your footage and render this again. We can then use After Effects or Nuke to put the details back onto our footage. Bring both of your footage into After Effects, duplicate your original clip with the details and pre-compose them together. Jump into the pre-comp, set the top layers mode to divide, and slap on a blur effect. The more blur you add, the more details pop out. Now head back to the main comp and set the pre-comp layer mode to multiply. Now you have details. Adjust the opacity to dial in the perfect amount of detail visibility, and you're good to go. Start by importing both of your footages into Nuke, the main render and the one with the details. First, add a blur node to the detail footage. The more you blur it, the more fine details you'll extract. Next, merge this blurred layer with itself just before the blur node, and set the merge operation to divide. Make sure to click on the merge node and press Shift X on your keyboard to swap the A and B inputs. Now take this result and merge it over your main render where you want to bring back the details. Change the merge operation to multiply. You can fine-tune the amount of detail by adjusting the mix slider to your liking. And that's it, you're done. I'll be putting some environment project files on my Patreon for free, so feel free to check them out for free. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to leave a like, drop a comment, and subscribe for more content like this. And I will see you in the next video.